in this department.
Why haven't I seen you around before? No, it's all right. I'll go ahead and take notes. Now, you said you were from which department? You're not sure.
Are you a mortal?
We don't usually see many of those up here. Let me guess, you've been sent here by some unknown deity, perhaps. Are you here for karmic reasons? Life lessons, probably. I'll just go ahead and make a note of that. We have a human. Do you have a name? Alright. And, cosmologically, do you know where you fall? I just mean, what is it? What sign are you? Is that what they call it? On which dimension? You live on Earth, okay. That narrows it down a little bit. Do you know which version of Earth you are from? I'll just go ahead and make a guess. Dimension 620. I think that's a pretty good guess. And, are you not even aware of? I see, so you must be an incarnating soul. Interesting. So, now, I suppose I should introduce myself as well. I am Capricornus, also referred to as Capricorn. Are you familiar at all? You are making one of those Zodiac journeys, aren't you? The last mortal we had doing that, it was, what, 700 years ago, perhaps. But then again, my sense of time is rather skewed, as it, time in our plane of existence isn't exactly lateral, or vertical, or whichever direction it's supposed to go. I apologize. I know it can be confusing, especially when you don't exactly belong in this dimension as of yet. Oh, you're wondering what sort of business we do here. Well, I manage the other signs, as you would call it. Yes, I'm sort of like the manager, I suppose you could say. Though I, in this department, we manage many other things besides just whatever my brothers and sisters get up to.
Yes, you know,
such as maintenance. And certain planes of existence we are actually fully in charge of. Yes, I have the unit in the back of the office. We have a couple incarnating souls there as well. Tie all into, what do you call it? Your realm, the matrix. I'm not sure what you would refer to it as. Matrix works. Interesting. Alright, well, this is rather entertaining, I must say. Normally I'm just busy taking notes of the same old thing, though there are often plenty of opportunities where I'm just putting out fires. But in the day in the life of the boss, I'm sure you understand. If you wouldn't mind, I'm going to input these notes into the system. It helps me keep track of it all, you understand? Now, tell me, what other Zodiacs have you run into? Oh, that's quite a few. When did you start? Your first answer. And then, it seems you've been going in order. Fascinating. We haven't had a specimen like you in quite some time. Now, if you wouldn't mind, could I take a closer look? You seem to be... rather out of sorts. You've been moving quickly. I apologize for the inconvenience. It must be a lot of work on your part. Your name and your sign and do you have a particular connection to me? The Capricorn sign. Well, it's just that I feel like I've seen you around somewhere before. You may have been a soul that I've claimed. In the alignment of the planets, I mean. Perhaps your moon or something. You just seem so familiar to me. If I haven't claimed you yet, perhaps I should. Oh, I'm sure all of my siblings are out for it now, since they've all met you personally. Oh well, I'll just put in my application. Since I am the one in charge of all the paperwork, perhaps I'll give myself a little edge, but that would be immoral, of course. Now, could you tell me a little bit about yourself? Do you find yourself, would you consider yourself to be an ambitious personality? Where do you feel that you fall elementally with your personality? Fire, earth, water, air. Perhaps you can include some mixes of those elements, such as ice, or thunder, electricity. You know what I mean? Where would you fall? Interesting. You could see yourself in any of them, but you feel most inclined towards which one? You don't have to answer mine. Mine, of course, is earth and water. Well, of course, you have to have some connection to the earth when you are in the water, don't you? To find your way. Well, it's hard to find people. Unmoving, yet forever in motion, like the tide. Like a relentless sea ship. Yes. I feel that you understand. You understand me. Perhaps we understand each other. Scheduled to see if I have time to fit in another mentee. Let's see. I seem to be all booked up for the foreseeable future, but I will add your name to the list. Excellent. Now, before you go, I'd like to analyze your energy a little bit, since you were sent here to me for a reason. I just want to make sure that you are satisfied with your trip to see me. Would you mind if I looked into the stars to see what I can do for you? What you need to hear in this moment from me? Adjustments are required. Perhaps you find yourself stuck in a situation that you can't foresee yourself getting out of. Well, the unfortunate thing is, the only person who can get you out of that situation is you. You may have to make some tough decisions, but it is a necessity for you to be able to finally realize your own happiness is within your control. That might mean cutting off some toxicity in your life, or changing your path, being daring, or having to choose responsibility for a little while to get yourself situated. Either way, the time to act is now. You can build yourself up. Take the time you need. Remember, you are going to have to make the choice to move forward. That being said, full moon in Virgo, you are good enough. You deserve the happiness you've been told your whole life was either a lie or something that was unachievable by you. The lie is in their words, not your hopes. You have the power to make the positive change you need to see. Remember to choose yourself first, before anyone else. You can only help others when you're ready to help yourself. And finally, the moon in Leo. That guy's a lot of work, isn't he? Confidence is your key to success. It has been my key to success in my endeavors, and I believe that is true of you as well. You lack confidence and appreciation in yourself. And once you can see how beautiful and amazing you are, how you've been put here for a very specific cosmological purpose, only then can you realize your worth and become worthy of yourself. I hope that helps you at all in any way. Unfortunately, I have many things to do, so I will be sending you forward into the next Zodiac, of course, since that seems to be the trajectory of your journey. Well, until we meet again, travel.